It's AumSum time!
What is Gigantism? Mm.
It's the nickname of my friend the Great Hulk.
Nah. In our brain, a pea-sized structure called the pituitary gland produces growth hormone, helping regulate and increase our height, girth, weight, etc. However, in some rare conditions, a non-cancerous tumor in the pituitary gland can trigger it to produce far more growth hormone than the body requires, leading to a large, tall stature, and thus causing gigantism. One example of this condition is Igor Vovkovinskiy, the current tallest man in the United States. His height is 7 feet 8.33 inches. According to experts, in such cases, the internal organs might become much bigger than their normal size. Yeehaw! However, on the flip side, gigantism may lead to deformities in the muscles and bones, making it difficult for the person to perform daily tasks like walking, running, etc. What is sinusitis?
It is a collection of chocolate pastries.
Nah. In our skull bones, there are hollow spaces which open into the nasal cavity. These are called paranasal sinuses or just sinuses. There are four types of sinuses: maxillary, ethmoid, sphenoid, and frontal. All of them produce mucus, helping moisten the inhaled air. Now, sinusitis refers to a condition in which one or more sinuses get inflamed, creating pain or a headache. There are various causes of sinusitis. Firstly, infection caused due to harmful viruses, bacteria, and fungi. Secondly, anatomical deformities in which the sinus openings are too small, making it difficult to drain the excess mucus. As a result, it becomes an ideal environment for illness-causing germs. Lastly, smoke or allergens like pollen, dust, etc. can also lead to sinusitis. Now, acute sinusitis usually lasts up to 4 weeks. Subacute sinusitis persists for 4 to 12 weeks. Chronic sinusitis lasts for more than 12 weeks. Recurrent sinusitis occurs when there are 3 or more episodes of sinusitis within 1 year. What is sleep apnea?
The ability to sleep 24/7.
No. Sleep apnea is a sleep disorder in which breathing is repeatedly interrupted during sleep. There are 3 types of sleep apnea. First is obstructive sleep apnea, in which the muscles and soft tissues present at the back of our throat relax and collapse, blocking the breathing passage and thus preventing the inhaled air from reaching the lungs. Second is central sleep apnea, in which our brain fails to send appropriate signals to the muscles that control breathing. Now, although the breathing passage is open, the muscles don't perform their tasks, hence breathing stops. Third is mixed sleep apnea, in which a person suffers from obstructive sleep apnea as well as central sleep apnea. Now, in all the above 3 types, lack of oxygen and shortness of breath trigger our brain to wake us up from sleep so that we can start breathing again. What is BMI?
Burger with mango ice cream.
Nah. BMI stands for Body Mass Index. It is used to check whether we have a healthy weight according to our height. BMI is calculated by dividing a person's weight in kilograms with his height in meters squared. A BMI of 18.49 or below indicates that the person is underweight. 18.5 to 24.99 is considered as normal weight. 25 to 29.99 overweight, and a BMI of 30 or more is considered as obese. Thus, BMI helps doctors to categorize our overall health. However, some experts think that this method is not accurate. Why? Because BMI doesn't distinguish between fat and muscle mass. So, for example, if a person has more well-defined muscle mass and less fat levels, BMI will categorize him as obese. Also, a person having less muscle mass and more amount of harmful visceral fat may be considered healthy by BMI. Lastly, BMI doesn't even take into account an individual's age, gender, etc. What is blood pressure?
It's a form of acupressure.
Now, in order to deliver oxygen and nutrients to each and every cell of our body, our heart pushes blood through tubes called blood vessels. As the blood moves, it exerts force on the vessel's walls. The measurement of this force of blood on the walls is called blood pressure. The ideal blood pressure reading is about 120 over 80 millimeters of mercury, or slightly below it. But why does the reading have two numbers? It is because our heart is constantly contracting and relaxing. During a phase called systole, our heart contracts to push the blood through arteries, thus increasing the pressure. So, the bigger number indicates the systolic blood pressure. Whereas during diastole, our heart relaxes, decreasing the pressure. So, the smaller number indicates the diastolic blood pressure.